Yesterday we came to an end with the unit of biodiversity and its conservation. Though the unit has come to an end, don't think that we have to stop taking few steps. Already you started taking some of these baby steps towards conservation of the biodiversity. Hope you are all following small steps, isn't it? Don't learn and limit it to textbook alone. Carry it with you. Some things which you can implement in your day-to-day life so that we can make our own life better and make this world a better place to live. I hope you will do that. So with this on page number, I think there is an annex here explaining on page number 100, there is a list of national park and sanctuaries in Telangana and Andhra Pradesh. This is just extra information given to you. See that you read whatever extra information is given to you. So today we are going to begin a new unit, a new chapter. The name of the chapter is Different Ecosystems. When I say ecosystem, if you take an example of forest, in forest there is a wide variety or wide range of what? Different animals. Like there is tiger, there is rabbit, there are foxes. All these are the wide range of animals found in the forest ecosystem. If you go to the pond ecosystem or ocean, sea, you can see there are dolphins, large fishes, small fishes. Then there are some plants which are growing in water. So that means there are some flora, fauna. Oh, flora is, remember, plants. Fauna is animals. So this ecosystem we are going to learn in this lesson, different ecosystems. When I say different ecosystems, first this term ecosystem was coined by the British botanist A.G. Tansley. A.G. Tansley. Who is this person or who is this botanist? A British botanist. Now who is botanist? One who studies about the subject botany. Botany means what is it? It's the study of plants. Zoology, study of animals. So here he is a British botanist who is an ecologist. Ecology means study of the environment, study of our surroundings. He firstly used the word ecosystem. What is this ecosystem? It is just the basic unit. We are saying nature, nature, nature. So this nature has so many units in that. In that unit, the basic unit, like for a building, which is the basic unit, we say it's the brick. Building as such is a big thing. But what was the basic unit from where we started that building was the brick. So in this nature, which is the basic unit? The basic unit is nothing but ecosystem. Because nature, when we say nature, it is working in combination or it is taking place in different interrelationships. Interrelationship of what? Living factors. Living factors, what are the living factors? They are called as biotic. So what are living factors? Biotic factors. Then there are some non-living factors. Non-living factors is nothing but abiotic. So biotic factors means living factors. Abiotic is nothing but non-living factors. So these biotic factors, what are the examples? You know, you have plants, you have animals. Again, you have some microorganisms which can be seen only under microscope. So microorganisms. So all this together forms our biotic factors. Biotic factor is clear? Living factor. Example, plants, animals, microorganisms. All these factors together are called as living factors or biotic factors. Now if I say what are abiotic factors? Abiotic factors means non-living factors. Like if you want the it will not grow by itself, isn't it? It has to take the nutrients. Nutrients from where? From the soil. So this soil, it takes oxygen from where? From the air. So air, that also forms what? Biotic or abiotic? Abiotic. So this all things together forms our abiotic factors. So that means in ecosystem, there is a unit. That is the unit of nature. In that we are going to study about habitat. Habitat, what did I say habitat? Natural living place. What is a habitat for a fish? Water. So habitat is nothing but natural living place. Then we have biome. Biome means living. So living factors, what are those? Flora and fauna. Flora is plants. Fauna is animals. So you can see some flora and fauna in particular areas. Polar bear, you can see only in Arctic and Antarctic or polar region. So like that. And ecosystem. Finally comes the ecosystem. So this together, there are some interrelationship between these different components of what? Ecosystem. So if you come to page 104, they have given one lab activity to show the structure of ecosystem. So ecosystem structure they have made, showed it here. So in this ecosystem, two components very important, biotic and abiotic. Biotic, bio means living. Living factors and non-living factors. They interact with one another. Did you follow? So if you look at the page 105, you can see the relationship between biotic and biotic components. If you look at that, biotic components means there is plants and animals. If you see an example, you have always seen that there is a food chain. You know what is food chain? Food chain is nothing but the relationship between food and feeder. Like plants. We'll take one small example. Plants. Who are the ones we tell it is being eaten by, we say? Suppose we take examples of insect like grasshopper. Then this grasshopper, what does it mean? It is being eaten by who? We say frog. You can take any hen also eats. So frog. Then this frog taken up by who? Snakes. So this is a simple food chain. This food chain can be again further linked. As you said, grasshopper can be eaten by hen. This hen can be eaten by man. Okay. These snakes will be eaten by somebody named one big bird, hawk, eagle, or mongoose. It differs, see? This is called, this is a simple food chain. But this food chain can be interlinked with one another. So food chain, now if it is interlinked with one another, it becomes a food web. So this is interdependence. Interdependence means you saw here the relationship, feeding relationship between plants and what are these? These are the animals. So this is interrelationship. Sometimes it is for food, sometimes it is for space, sometimes for reproduction. Like you sow 100 seeds. From that 100 seeds, only 50 may germinate. Because there is a competition there for space. There is competition for taking more and more nutrients. So that is, it may depend on space, reproduction, or for shelter. So now, all these organisms, where are they? In which unit are they? They are in the ecosystem. We told biotic and abiotic. So they all depend on plants. Remember, each and every component depends on plants. For what? For food. Because plants are the primary or the basic producers or universal producers. plant get its source from? Where is this plant getting its energy from? This sun. And it is preparing food by the process of photosynthesis. So which is the source of energy for plants? It is sunlight or sun. And these plants are eaten by animals. That means animals indirectly depend on plants. Plants depending on sunlight, energy. So in this way you can see interdependence. So here you have to remember the name of that botanist or ecologist, A.G. Tansley, who first coined the term ecosystem. In ecosystem, biotic factors, abiotic factors. And there is interdependence. Interdependence means food and feeder or feeding relationship. So remaining we will continue in the next class. Thank you.